is on there on the communications in the Linux. So these are the learning outcomes. At end of these sessions, the students will be able to demonstrate the Linux networking commands. So first we'll try to understand how we are going to make the communication and why the commands are necessary to study in Linux. So in these videos, we will discuss in detail about the network communications utilities in Linux. So when you are working in a distributed environment or you need to communicate with other remote users, and you also need to access the remote Linux machines. So to access this, there are several Linux utilities that help us users to compute in the network and the distributed environments. For this, there are some basic utilities that you can make use of it. These utilities can help you to communicate with the networks, other Linux systems, and other remote users. So let us learn one by one. So SSH, ping, FTP, telnet, and IF are some of the utilities used in the Linux environment. So now in detail, we are going to see what is ping. So this utility is commonly used to check whether your connection is to the server is healthy or not. Means your connection is established to that server or the client. This command is also used in analyzing the network and the host connections. Next, the tracking the environment performance and the managing it. And one more is there, that is the testing hardware and software issues. The syntax used for the ping is ping host name or the IP address. IP address is the given to each and every machine, which is different for each and every machine. Next, you are going to see a protocol that is known as an FTP. The FTP is a file transfer protocol. It is the most preferred protocol for the data transferring amongst the computers. So you can also use FTP for the logging in and the establishing a connections with the remote host, upload and the download files, navigating through directories, browsing the contents of the directories. So the syntax used for the FTP commands is the FTP host name or the IP address. By these protocols, you can upload or download the files which are at the remote login place. Next is the telnet. The telnet helps us to connect the remote Linux machines and run program remotely and the conduct administration. This utility is similar to the remote desktop features found in the Windows machines. The syntax used for this utility is telnet localhost or the whatever the IP address is there. So we have to use this as a syntax for the telnet. Next one is the most important, that is an SSH. SSH, which stands for the secure shell, it is used to connect to the remote computer securely. Compared to the telnet, the SSH is a secure wherein the client-server connection is authenticated using the digital interface certificate and the password are encrypted. Hence, it is widely used by the system administrations to control the remote Linux servers. So there is a difference between the telnet and SSH servers, which in SSH has the digital certificate and passwords are encrypted, whereas in the telnet it is not there. So it is widely used by the system administration to control the remote Linux servers. The syntax used to log in the remote Linux machine using SSH is SSH username at the IP address or the host name, that is the name of that machine. So now we will see the demo of all above commands in the Linux terminal. So now we'll switch over the Linux terminal. So as you know, this is a Linux terminal. So we'll see one by one the command used for the networking in the Linux. First, we'll see what is an IP address of a machine. So for that, we have to put the command, that is ifconfig. So by this, using this command, we can see the IP address of that machine. So inet, this is the IP address for this machine, 198.168.127.128. And this is the netmask and this is the broadcast address for this IP. The IP is given to connect each and every local machines and other distributed environment here. Without an IP, you cannot connect to that machine. So it is very important to first see that what is an IP of that machine. So to see that, So we have to use the command ifconfig in the Linux terminal. So now we'll see one more command that is useful to connect see the connections between the two machines, that is the ping command. So as we have seen in the previous slide, so how to connect the two machines with the ping command. So for that, first we have to type ping 192.168.151. So is there reply from that machine? So that means this machine is connected to that network. So the network is different here. It was 127.128, and this network is different in connection, that is 40.151 here. So this is the reply given by that machine. So the packet will be sent from this machine to that machine, and that machine will acknowledge to this packet. So these two machines are remotely, now we can connect remotely. And the protocol used for the ping command is ICMP, that is Internet Control Message Protocol. So to stop this, we have to make use of the control C. So by using this command, we can check the connection between the two machine. So now we'll see the FTP connections. So the FTP is used to see the upload or download the files from the remote place here. So the IP address for that, the syntax to establish the FTP connection to the remote host is the FTP host name or the IP address, that is FTP dot So we have seen that we have connected to an FTP server, that is ftp.javatutorial.hub.com. So it is connected to the javatutorialhub.com. Now you can log in and you can use the number from 1 to 50 as are allowed. So the local time is now this, and the server port number is 21 here. So once you enter in this command, you will ask for the authentication via username and password. So now we have to enter here username and the password here. So after this, so once the connection is established and you are logged in, you may use the following commands that you perform the different action. The following command means, if you want to upload the file, then you have to make use of the put command, that is put file, upload the file from the local to the remote server. And if you want to get the file from the remote place or the where the connection has been made, then you have to download the file from the remote to the local computer, or quit. So if you write quit, so it will get logout. So the user quitted, the password is required for that also. So for that we have to write exit. So now we'll see the telnet, how the telnet is connected. Telnet is connected, the syntax used for that is the telnet or the IP address or the host name, that is 128.151. So it is trying to connect, but right now it is telnet utility is not installed on this machine, so it is giving a message unable to connect here. If you try to install the telnet on this machine, so you will be able to connect this machine. Okay, next we will see SSH, how the SSH is connected. It is secure shell, okay. And the syntax used to log in the remote Linux machine using SSH is SSH, the username at IP address or the host name, that is beaver at /151. So it will ask the password. So now we have connected to the remote machine, that is beaver at bionic beaver here. So from that we can see there where we are now. For that we have to make use of an pwd, that is home at beaver. So we can do what are the files are there on the beaver machines. So ls command is used. So these are the files on that machine. So we have remotely logged in for that. So it is secure as compared to the telnet because the passwords are encrypted and the digital certification is required for that. Okay, so now pause the video and answer the question, which command is used to check the IP of a particular machine in the Linux? So the answer is ifconfig. So if you want to exit from the remote login machine, so we have to write exit here. So now the connection has been closed here. Okay, so these were the demonstration for the networking. If you want to connect to a remote machine, so there are few examples like this we have to connect. So now these are my references. Thank you.